How many times have you heard that your body may be too acidic, or your body may be too alkaline, or that eating certain foods makes your body acidic and that you have various health issues and emotional, mental health issues as a result of your body acidity being wrong? Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist and a biologist. And in this video, we're going to talk about what that actually means. What is acidic? What is not acidic? How do you know? And does it matter what you eat? Is it going to do any harm to your body acidity, if body acidity is actually even a thing? Right. One of the things you hear most often is eating meat makes your body acidic, which is one of the arguments that non-meat eaters like to use to make you think that you shouldn't eat meat. So what does that mean, and how does it happen? Okay, acidity is measured on a scale called the pH scale, which runs from 1 to 14. The lower the number, the more acidic. The higher the number, the less acidic, or the more alkaline, which is, alkaline is the opposite of acid. So a 7 on the pH scale, from 1 to 14, is neutral, like pure water would be a 7. Okay, the chemistry, the biochemistry that goes on in your body is all happening in liquid, in your blood, in your cell liquids, in your joint liquids. Everything is in liquid. That's where the chemical reactions take place. And the acidity, or the pH level of the fluid in which your various processes are happening, is very important because it affects the way those reactions work. And so in different parts of your body, in different areas of your body, the pH level, the ideal pH level, is different. So the pH level in your blood, for example, is about 7.4, which is mildly, mildly alkaline, because it's just up, just above pure water, which is 7. It needs to be 7.4 for everything to operate. And it's a very narrow requirement, because if it goes up to 8, you die. If it goes down to 7, you die. It's sitting at about 7.4. It is strictly controlled and strictly managed by your kidneys that will take acid out or release acid back in so that it stays at that level and keeps you functioning properly. Right, that's your blood. When you have a blood test, if they do test your pH, it's always going to be about 7.4. The only time it isn't, if it really goes out, you are already having kidney failure and you should be in the ICU. It's not going to help you to go on a one-week retreat to eat certain foods and meditate and restore your acid level. You'll be dead before you even get there. So your blood acidity, 7.4, that's it. The fluid around your cells is also about 7.4. That's the extracellular fluid. The intracellular fluid inside your cells is slightly more acidic, and so it's a little bit lower, maybe 7.2, maybe down as low as 7. And different tissues, so different types of cells at different times, can vary quite significantly, and they can be as low as 5 or as high as 8. And it does have fluctuations. Skeletal cells, for example, are slightly more acidic than some of the other cells in your body. So even within the cell itself, the acidity or the pH level is strictly controlled according to the function of the cell, according to the enzyme activity that is going on, and according to the proteins that are in that cell, because they will be affected by the acidity. So again, it's very strictly controlled, though it's not the same as it is, for example, in the blood. The synovial fluid in your joints is also about 7.4. Now, if you have osteoarthritis, it tends to go up a little bit. If you have rheumatoid arthritis, it tends to go down a little bit, but not by very much, a couple of decimal points at the most, and that is also maintained quite closely. Now we go to the stomach. The acid in your stomach is incredibly strong. It's hydrochloric acid for the most part, which is vicious. It's swimming pool acid, literally hydrochloric acid. And the acid in your stomach is anything between 1.5 and 3, which is incredibly low on the pH scale. So it is highly, highly, highly acidic, and it needs to be. It needs to be that acidic to break down the proteins in your food, and it is also a good buffer for any pathogens or microbes that you take in from food that's been infected and kill them before they go through into your digestive system. So very high acid in your stomach. Another place where we get to measure our acidity is in the bladder, the urine. Now the urine acidity varies hugely. It can be anything from 4.5 to 8, which so from quite strongly acid to alkaline. And that is because the kidney is processing acids and keeping the acids balanced in the body, and any excess acid or is going out in the urine, or if you're a little bit low in acid, it will retain some of the acid out of the urine, which leaves your urine slightly alkaline. So if you have a pH test on your urine and it's acidic, that is not a sign that your body is too acidic. That is a sign that your kidneys are working properly. They are voiding excess acid and keeping the levels in your blood, in your cells, level and stable where they should be. There is no one pH level for your body. That doesn't exist. Stomach, way more acidic than your blood. Inside the cells, outside the cells, there's also a gradient of acidity. So your body will control your acidity. It's got nothing at all to do with your preferred diet. So anybody who tries to tell you that you need an intervention, you need a special diet, you need to go on a retreat somewhere, you need to perform some kind of ritual to restore your body acidity, there are only two possibilities here. One is they are totally ignorant about how your body works. They probably don't even know what acidity means. They certainly don't know how your pH level and your acidity is regulated in your body, by your kidneys. So they're ignorant, or they know and they're taking advantage of you, and it's a scary sounding thing and they're making money out of you. So they are a fraud. So they're ignorant or they're a fraud. There's no other question to it. Thank you for your time. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel if you haven't already, because we love making videos like this and just putting things right when people have quite strange ideas and we are easily manipulated by people with these strange ideas who might have some kind of agenda. Oh, hey, one last thing before you go. If you enjoyed this video and you get value from our videos, you should consider becoming a member of the Shape Fixer Club for additional content and further benefits. Just click the join button below this video to find out what that's all about. It would be great to have you on board.